Americans reject DNC plans to pack Supreme Court. I like this picture that I picked for Joe there. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. This is court packing Supreme Court fallout polls panel. That's the topic report that we're looking for. And I originally called this topic court, two-thirds of Americans reject court packing, even as Biden forms panel to do just that. So 68%, that's more than two-thirds, but I was being generous, 68% oppose adding seats to Supreme Court, new polls finds. This is from Christian Headlines in an excerpt from ChristianHeadlines.com. A majority of registered voters in the United States oppose adding seats to the U.S. Supreme Court, according to a new survey that also found bipartisan resistance to the idea. The survey by Mason Dixon found that 68% of registered voters, including 98% of Republicans, 68% of independents, and 47% of Democrats. That means the majority of Democrats are for this. And I would be willing to bet if this poll was taken where the Republicans thought they were going to have the power as opposed to the Democrats, then you would see an exact flip. By the way, anybody that's moving to end the filibuster in Congress, they have in their head, they must have in their head that they will never, ever have to face a diminishment of power. That somehow, and I think this is what the DNC is really trying to do, create a one-party government so that they never have to worry about competition again. This is the nature of humanity. Whenever we have any kind of position of advantage, especially without Christ in our lives, but not necessarily, there are plenty of people that don't have Christ in their lives that I wouldn't say this about, but especially without Christ in their lives. And there are some people that claim to have Christ in their lives that still don't reflect this. We tend to want to kill competition, and that's what this is. This is about killing competition so they can pass their extreme, radical, anti-king bill that is Bill of Rights. The only true king, the only true leader in this land is King Bill. To be able to bypass all of these inconvenient hurdles to them being able to manipulate human beings on the fly to make them in their image rather than treat them as sacred beings in and of themselves. Well, you should be very nervous as an American citizen when you have a political party and its acolytes, and the majority of those acolytes support ending the filibuster, ending the reflection of a republic rather than a mobocracy. And you only favor a mobocracy when you imagine that you have the means to completely control the population with your agitprop, of which the DNC has every confidence that they have that power. The survey by Mason Dixon found that 68% of registered voters, including 90% of Republicans, I already said this, but I want to repeat that, 90% of Republicans, 68% of independents, only 68% of independents, unbelievable, and 47% of Democrats, shame on you, DNC. And if this was a story that I was reporting in which the Republicans were supporting a filibuster, I would be saying the same to the Republicans, shame on you. You're not truly acting like Americans. But then again, most people in these, the deeper you get into the factual alignment, the less likely you are to care that much about King Bill, because King Bill is an impediment to you being able to impose your will on others without their consent. So that's why, for instance, you have a republic as opposed to a democracy. A democracy is simply the rule of the majority, and with no checks and balances on what the majority can do to the minority. And that does not favor consensual exchange at all. If you favor consensual exchange, you would not be for the filibuster ending. Registered voters remained opposed to court packing when the question was rephrased to include a current Democratic proposal, although more Democratic voters backed the idea. And then we have just a little bit of a glimpse at some of the headlines here so you get a sense of what's going on. Commentary, the latest plan to pack the Supreme Court. From myjournalcourier.com. Benjamin Franklin said in 1789, our new constitution is now established. Everything seems to promise it will be durable, but in the world, nothing is certain except death and taxes. Apparently, there is one other certainty in this world. Democrats will try to pack the U.S. Supreme Court. And Roosevelt, it's going to point out, Roosevelt tried to do this in 1937. FDR was the last most well, he was the last far right leftist president that we had that perceived that he had the power to actually act in his far right leftism. So Biden, whatever Biden is, whether he is a real person or whether he is a collective that gives him his drugs and points him in the cameras and makes him read a script, some maybe some truth in between there. Whatever it is, the Biden, the collective, the individual, this entity has the perception that they have the power to pull off this level of republic killing programs to assure that the American people no longer have any type of viable choice. Not that they have, because the Republican Party has, as I've said many times, the Republican Party is essentially the Washington Generals, and the Democrat Party are the Harlem Globetrotters. And even, although in this scenario, even when the Washington Generals quote-unquote win, they really don't, because they don't fundamentally shift the balance of power in any way away from the continuing growing power of the DNC. So here's some other headlines here. House could urge Congress to maintain 9 U.S. Supreme Court justices. And North Carolina General Assembly could go on, this is the North Carolina House, could go on record opposing court packing proposals in Washington, D.C. And I'm sure hoping that a lot of states, and it, as it just so happened, it would have to be Republican, a lot of states may go on record to say, if you do this, we're not going to honor the Supreme Court. And I wouldn't. If you're going to pack the courts, then this is all a joke. Then this is all just whichever party is, quote unquote, in power, they can just pack the courts again. So every party that is in power, well, and you'll just have, and eventually we'll have like 89 Supreme Court justices. Oh, that'll be great. Biden's boneheaded idea to pack the Supreme Court, a danger to liberty. Like I said, and this is from DetroitNews.com, the last one was from MyDailyRecord.com. Like I said, you only do these things if you perceive that you have enough power to cut off competition, so you never have to worry about the competition doing to you what you're doing to them. And that should frighten Americans that value a republic over a mobocracy. Other opinions, Biden names his court packing panel. And here's a letter, packing Supreme Court is an unvarnished power grab from union leader. And then here's from The Hill, Americans agree court packing is dangerous. And finally, from IWF.org, court packing is a non-starter.